participate in this language conference on the theme, The Furtherance of Multilingualism in South Africa for an Equitable Future. On behalf of Her Excellency, Ambassador Minata Samate Sessouma, Commissioner for Health, Humanitarian Affairs and Social Development of the African Union Commission, I congratulate and thank PanSALB, the Pan-South African Language Board, for the efforts it is making to empower South African languages, and therefore African languages, and to encourage and promote multilingualism in the nation. The objective of this very important conference, amongst others, is to discuss on the implementation of multilingualism in the country since the advent of its constitutional democracy. What has been done, what remains to be done to be able to surmount difficulties and pave the way? This goes in line with the basic PanSALB mandate, which is to develop the official languages, the 11 official languages, plus South African Sign Language, and promote multilingualism in South Africa. Likewise, the African Academy of Languages, ACALAN, as the African Union Specialized Language Agency, has been entrusted with the task to work with member states of the African Union to develop and promote African languages as a means of fostering continental integration and development by encouraging the formulation and establishment of vigorous and articulated language policies and the sharing of experiences in policy making and implementation in the member states as a means of using African languages in a wider range of domains. In doing so, ACALAN establishes language commissions to develop and promote African languages, notably vehicular cross-border languages, on the basis that the development and promotion of African languages in a conducive atmosphere of convivial and functional multilingualism will serve to forge the linguistic and cultural unity of Africa. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, multilingualism is a reality in Africa because the national boundaries of African countries were drawn arbitrarily by the colonial powers during the time of the partition of Africa, paying no regard to the historical, cultural, and linguistic affinity of Africans, thus creating extremely mixed populations and a very complex and varied language situation. Distinct ethnic groups became assembled in European colonies, while other ethnic groups found themselves divided by newly established artificial borders and were separated into two or more territories administered by different colonial powers. The colonizers externally imposed arbitrary borders, creating extremely mixed populations. Post-independent African governments faced the dilemma on how to bring together different ethno-linguistic groups and how to build in heavily multilingual and multi-ethnic states inherited from colonialism. Africa, ladies and gentlemen, is the most multilingual continent in this world, and there are very few countries with more than 90% ethnic and linguistic homogeneity of population, where one African language is spoken by the people as a mother tongue. For example, Somalia, Somali, Eswati, Seswati, Botswana, Setswana, Burundi, Kirundi, Lesotho, Sesotho, Rwanda, Kinyarwanda, etc. In some other countries, one African language is spoken by the vast majority of the population as a lingua franca. Kiswahili in Tanzania, Wolof in Senegal, Bambara in Mali. This made African governments to continue to depend on ex-colonial metropolitan languages: English, French, Portuguese, Spanish, as languages of administration and in education, to the detriment of African languages. The multilingualism prevailing in most African countries, however, is an asset, an essential in that it ensures that all languages within the boundaries of member states are recognized and accepted as a source of mutual enrichment, liberates the African peoples from undue reliance on the utilization of non-African languages, ensures that African languages, by appropriate legal provision and practical promotion, assume their rightful role as the means of communication in the public affairs of member states, encourages the increased use of African languages as vehicles of instruction at all levels of the education system, empowers the local community by supporting and deepening community participation through the promotion of the use of African languages, and fosters tolerance and respect for others, and hence promotes dialogue and peace. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, we are living in an increasingly complex and multicultural and globalized world, marked by migration, dialogue for peace and sustainable solutions. Therefore, multilingualism and linguistic diversity are essential to guaranteeing people their own identities while being able to understand and respect other cultures. Multilingualism opens dialogue between languages and establishes dialogue amongst people and promotes peace and sustainable development. Cross-border languages, ladies and gentlemen, are languages spoken by a population, a nation, or an ethnic group that lives in a geographical area in two or several internationally recognized countries that have common land or maritime borders. In an atmosphere of multilingualism, transborder languages are a factor of commerce, trade, cooperation, collaboration, peace and solidarity, and therefore of integration and development. They have the potential of serving as a model for development, especially if they are widely spoken, because they have a large population to support them. And materials prepared in one country can be shared and used in others. To expand their use should not be difficult once the necessary language development work has been undertaken. A good example of this is Kiswahili. With more than 200 million speakers, the majority of which lives on the African continent, particularly in East and Central Africa, which Kiswahili ACALAN is now promoting as a working language of the African Union and a language of wider communication in Africa. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I would take this opportunity to record that the heads of state and government of the member states of the African Union, during the 35th ordinary session in February 2022, adopted the Dar es Salaam framework for action that ACALAN had developed as a collective commitment to action to ensure that Article 25 of the Constitutive Act of the African Union, previously Article 29 of the Charter of the Organization of African Unity, is implemented by promoting Kiswahili, an African language, as a working language of the African Union and a language of wider communication in Africa. The consultative meeting for the East African region in Kigali, Republic of Rwanda, on 10 and 11 May 2022, recommended that ACALAN engage in language policy advocacy to ensure all member states develop language policies that give status and valorizing functions to African languages and recognize Kiswahili as a working language of the African Union and language of wider communication in Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, ACALAN launched the African Languages Week in Ouagadougou in collaboration with the government of Burkina Faso in July 2021. The launch of the African Languages Week was in line with its adoption by the Third Specialized Technical Committee on Youth, Culture and Sport of the African Union in October 2018 in Algiers, Algeria, based on a proposal of the Executive Secretariat of the African Academy of Languages. The African Languages Week is a perpetual rendezvous and a major annual event to be held from 24 to 30 January that should be observed by all member states of the African Union to commemorate the relevance of African languages and cultures in Africa and the African diaspora. As a special moment of the African identity, it is a pathway of realizing Agenda 2063 of the African Union, specifically Aspiration 5, that promotes an Africa with strong cultural identity, common heritage, shared values and ethics. The theme of the inaugural edition of the African Languages Week for the year 2022 was linked to the 2021 theme of the African Union, which was Arts, Culture and Heritage, Levers for Building the Africa We Want. Therefore, the theme of the African Languages Week for 2022 was African Languages, Levers for the Africa We Want. Likewise, as part of the recommendations of the preparatory meetings, the theme of the 2023 African Languages Week was suggested to be African Languages for Sustainable Food Security, Cultural and Socioeconomic Development for the Africa We Want, in line with the African Union theme for 2022, which is strengthening resilience in nutrition and food security on the African continent, strengthening agro-food systems, health and social protection systems for the acceleration of human, social and economic capital development, reflecting on the African Union's theme for 2022. In the same vein, the slogan for the year 2023 was set as "What we speak and what we eat makes Africa great." Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, before concluding, I would like to reiterate that multilingualism is key to mutual enrichment, to the mutual enrichment of our languages, of our people, of our system, of our values, of our norms. It is a factor of dialogue and discipline, peace, progress, and prosperity. I would like to thank the Pan-South African Language Board and the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture of the Republic of South Africa and the entire government of people of South Africa. On behalf of Her Excellency, Ambassador Minata Samate Sessouma, Commissioner for Health, Humanitarian Affairs and Social Development of the African Union Commission, for your remarkable PanSALB, the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, for your remarkable and collective efforts, the entire people of South Africa, for your collective effort in empowering South African languages, African languages, in an atmosphere of functional multilingualism. The African Academy of Languages, ACALAN, on behalf of the African Union, will continue to collaborate with the Pan-South African Language Board to continue developing and promoting African languages and promoting multilingualism on the African continent. Long live the Republic of South Africa. Long live the African Union. Long live the African Academy of Languages. Long live the Pan-South African Language Board. African languages for a peaceful, prosperous, integrated, and healthy Africa. Asante sana.